La biodiversité est au fondement de la vie humaine.
Biodiversity is the starting point of human life. For thousands of years in all ecosystems, specialized communities have existed, driving their subsistence from biodiversity gatherers, hunter-gatherers, coastal fishermen, or shepherds. The various activities are the basis for the way of life for many modern societies. Hunting efficacy, for instance, is based on a very refined knowledge of the prey reaction when the idea is to cause a certain type of behavior. In hunting, there is a direct relationship between man and the hunted animal, whereas traps are a machine, a device prepared to catch the animal in the absence of the man who set the trap. Immobile preys, invisible preys in an environment that is difficult to access. This describes fishing. For fishing, you have to know exactly where the animals that you're trying to catch live in order to set a number of devices to catch the fish. Either the devices are active, moved by the fishermen, harpoons, lines or nets. But otherwise, the device can be passive, placed at the bottom of the sea, and the prey will get caught or trapped by the device. Gathering is about all kinds of products from plants, leaves, fruit, seed, roots, animals, insects, mussels, and also products which will be used for handicraft, especially basket weaving. Gathered products have been sold over long distances for centuries now. And for instance, in Paris nowadays, we consume seeds that have been collected in the Amazonian forest. With agriculture, by transforming the soil and the vegetation, we create new ecosystems called agroecosystems. The farmer prepares the soil, tills it, replaces the vegetation with cultivated plants that are being sown. The main concern is how to create and maintain fertility in the soil in order to feed the plants by adding vegetal matter, animal or even human matter, or also by associating plants together, growing together plants, one of which provides the other some minerals, or by planting different plants in succession with a rotation, or possibly also leaving the soil to rest by a system of fallow. And it is also necessary to provide water to the soil, and this means that the farmer needs to know the rain cycle or has to have irrigation techniques to build channels or puddles for rice culture. The breeder must feed his herd, and there is complementarity here between agriculture and breeding. Agricultural products will be shared between the human community and the animal community. Livestock can be taken out to graze in meadows and forests, and nomadic shepherds can move their animals to graze over very long distances. The livestock has always played a very important part in agriculture. It provides working strength to pull equipment or provides fertilizers in the fields when the animals are left to graze the field once the crop has been collected. All of these activities are complementary with each other, and men and women do not do the same work, so this activity is gender dependent, and sometimes societies work together and exchange their products because they specialize in a certain type of production, sometimes over very long distances. This means that local knowledge, ecological knowledge, must be used, expressed in specialized terminology on plants, animals and ecosystems, plant, animals and ecosystems, species that are recognized, denominated and classified. And this is the starting point for technical clinical practices. And this is the study object for ethnoecology, which is all about understanding the articulation between the knowledge, the practice, and the ecological characteristic of the resources that man tries to either gather, collect, or produce.